So you have to set up RC circuit, which means you need to set up capacitance. You have to set up a capacitance, capacitor with the resistor serially. And then you have to have a power supply and battery and the switch, right? So this is switch one, this is the battery, this is capacitance, this is resistance. Now when you switch on, what will happen? This is positive and negative. The current try to pass through the capacitor. Actually, current is not really passing through the capacitor. What it really does is this plate is starting to charge positively. As a result, the other plate is starting to charge negatively. Okay. After a while, this capacitor will fully charge. When it fully charge, if you have a ammeter here, if you set up an ammeter here, you will see current passing through will become zero. At that point, if you observe or measure the voltage across this capacitor, when it is fully charged, if I have a voltmeter here, when it fully charged, then this capacitor voltage across the capacitor plate should be equal to the external voltage supply VDC or the battery voltage, maximum battery power. That is called the charging capacitor. When you observe the voltage and then charge for the charging capacitor, let's say I measure the voltage of the charging capacitor in unit of volt, and as a function of time in second, then if you draw this VC versus time, then you will get voltage is slowly increasing initially, rapidly increasing initially, linearly, and then after some time it's look like it's starting to saturate. So it's look like that. So this is actually called the charging capacitor behavior. Now why this behavior happened, the reason is that we're going to analyze this in detail today's class, okay? So if you take a look, the behavior of charging capacitor voltage is actually look like this. Voltage for charging capacitor is some V0 parentheses 1 minus e to the power minus t over tau. This tau is called the time constant that is equal to the multiplication of R and C. R is in unit ohms and the capacitance is unit of farad, right? If you take a look this in detail, the unit here, R is on volt divided by current. Volt is unit voltage divided by the current is unit amp, right? Capacitance, on the other hand, from the Q equals CV, charge divided by the voltage, right? Amperes, on the other hand, voltage divided by amperes is coulomb divided by second. Now, if you multiply these units together, units only, okay, multiply the unit itself, then you will get the unit of time. So multiply the R and C unit itself. R has the unit of V over Q divided by C over S, and the unit of capacitance is actually C, coulomb divided by unit of volt, coulomb divided by unit of volt. Volt cancels out, coulomb cancels out. This goes to the numerator. So the RC has a unit of second. That is unit of time. So that's the idea. That's why this is called the time constant. Okay. So that's the reason. We will take a look this in detail, this equation, how to develop that equation and all the information during the today's class. Okay. Now, the whole idea is that this time constant RC is actually unit of time. Because of that right here, you will not get any unit because this is exponential. You should not have any units there, okay? It should be just a number. All of those are very, very important to understand this equation, how this equation is developed, why the equation is look like that, whether the equation is correct or wrong in terms of physics one. Chapter one, you know how to identify the equation, all of those things, right? Inside right here, there should not be any units. Inside right here, there should not be any unit. Unit of voltage is coming only from there. To don't have any unit, time constant should have to have the unit of time. So that's what we have seen here, okay? Now, this is exponential growth, right? Which means, for example, if you plug t equals 0 there, t equals 0 there, then the e to the power 0 is 1, then you will get voltage 0. That's what you're observing right here. Now, if you plug t goes to infinity, then you will get 0 there, then you will get Vc goes to the maximum voltage, what we call V0, that is the supplied voltage. That's why you can see this curve is exponentially growing and then is starting to saturate. When the T goes to infinity, voltage becomes saturated to the supplied voltage. Make sense? So that's the behavior of charging capacitor. That's behavior we're going to observe by setting up this equation. Good. Good question. No question. Okay, then let's take a look at the discharging capacitor quickly. Now, if I have a discharging capacitor, discharging means what you're going to do, you're going to first charge this capacitor fully. You have a capacitor and resistor, switch and the battery, S1. Then you're going to open this switch, keep switch one open. There's no, this loop is not connected. You're going to get another wire and then connected this capacitor this side. You're creating another loop, another switch, and this side. This is actually switch two. Now, if you close this switch two, what will happen? There's no power supply connected. Capacitor is fully charged, which means it has charges. It will try to emit the charges. This side positively charged, negatively charged. If we close this switch, the current will pass through there on this loop, upper loop. That is called the discharging circuit, okay? Now, this is the discharging circuit. Discharging circuit. So as a result of that power passing through there, if I analyze in the discharging circuit, same thing, we're going to measure voltage across capacitor as a function of time. Then we're going to draw this data and then make a graph. So let's make a graph time versus voltage across capacitor. If you do that graph, you can see initially you have a maximum voltage because capacitor is fully charged, right? When the time equals zero, voltage across capacitor is the voltage of the battery. As the time goes on, this will slowly decrease because there's no power supply, and then eventually it will become zero. So your graph going to be look like that, exponentially decaying graph. So if you analyze this circuit by using the theory, then you will get an equation, voltage across capacitor is a function of time, maximum voltage times e to the minus t over tau. It's the same equation. Now that one minus part is not there. Reason, when t equals zero, your Vc should be equal to V0 or the E. And if you have a t goes to infinity, then your Vc must goes to zero. That can be validated only if your exponential decay equation is look like that. Got it? Any question so far? All right. Now, we're going to take a look at these two very quickly. Okay, that's the idea. So we're going to measure these and then we're going to check this behavior. Now, there is one quick thing we need to do when we're doing this calculation. You know how the graph should look like. Charging capacitor should be look like this. Exponentially increasing and then saturate. T versus Vc. Discharging capacitor should be look like this. It's starting at the same number right here. And then decreasing and then goes to zero after some time. Okay, this is charging. And then this is discharging. So what we're going to do now, we know how to calculate the tau. Tau is called time constant, which is R times C, right? So if we know the R value, C value, we can calculate that. So what we're going to do in the experiment, by using this observed result, we're going to calculate this tau again. We're going to calculate this one by using this graph, tau 1, tau 2. We're going to compare these two and then these two. And then measure the percent, calculate the percentage difference. That's the plan, okay? Now, to calculate this tau, it is actually a little bit tough with the exponential curve, because in your Excel, you can't really do any different fitting. So you can do only selected fitting. We don't have this kind of equation fitting for Excel. This equation is not possible to do in Excel, okay? Only way to do that is actually by using like MATLAB or Igor or Origin, or there are other software which we can do, but we are not using any of them. We try to use all the Excel. Because of that, what we're going to do, I'm going to take this equation for charging capacity, 1 minus e to the t over tau. We're going to linearize this one. So that called the data manipulation. So you have exponential curve here. We'll take the exponential curve and then we will linearize this one by manipulating this one, okay? How to do it? So you rearrange this equation, Vc over V0 equal 1 minus e to the t over tau. And then let's do a couple of adjustment, e to the minus, keep this one here and then bring 1 into this side, multiply by negative 1, then you will get Vc over V0. Minus 1 parenthesis e to the minus t over tau. Then take the ln on both sides, natural log on both sides, then you will get ln Vc over V0 minus 1. If you take the ln of exponential, exponential cancels out, it's going to be minus 1 over tau times the time. Then you make a graph between these two. This whole thing is y, time is your x. If you do that graph, slope of that graph is 1 over tau. So that's the plan. So we're going to make a new graph, time versus Vc over V0 minus 1 ln of that. That is y-axis, x-axis is time. You will get a graph like that. Then fit that graph, take the slope of the graph. That slope is actually negative. Slope will be some negative number, let's say negative a. That negative a should be equal negative 1 over tau. Make sense? Right? Got it? Any question? So which means from there I can calculate the tau, right? That's the plan. Very simple calculation. Very simple lab, but you can see there's a lot of theory, okay? So that theory part we will discuss again, end of the today's class. Good, any questions so far? Now, the lot of question you have, the most of the time you have physics lab, there's a lot of work we do, why we do those lot of calculation, lot of things. You're not going to do this kind of lab. If you're doing this real lab in physics classes, these are like 400-year-old physics we're doing, right? So what you carry over is actually these kind of analysis. So that's, I pointed out every semester. Because if you take a look at this analysis, that is the one you actually carry over. This is data manipulation, data modeling, things like that. That's what you need in your next step. If you don't practice that and then don't learn those kind of thing in your physics class, then the physics class itself has no meaning. Because you're not going to do this this kind of experiment in your field. Most of you are going to become engineers, right? As engineer nowadays, what you do? You have a large data set, you analyze that, you manipulate it, and then you try to model that. So that's this part right here we will be doing. That's a simple, very basic level, but that is how this modeling is start, right? So we're going to do the same thing for the discharging capacitor. Discharging capacitor, Vc is V0 e to the minus t over tau. That's the equation. You linearize this by manipulating. How to linearize? Same concept, right? Vc over V0, e to the minus t over tau, take the ln both side, ln Vc over V0, which is equal minus 1 over tau, times the t. Then you take this whole thing as a y, this is as a x, this whole thing will be your slope, y equal mx graph. But m is negative, okay? This is time, this is ln Vc over V0, then you take the slope of the graph. Let's say slope is minus b. That minus b is equal minus 1 over tau. Good, any question so far? Okay, so the lab itself not much difficult. Okay, now this part is actually difficult. So you have to take a look again when you're doing the lab report. Try to get more understanding that actually will be useful. How the real charging look like, but how we're gonna manipulate that equation to get that graph look like linear. So this is the graph we expecting, but this is actually what we're really analyzing. So that's our manipulated equation. Okay. Good, any question? Okay, then let's build this circuit and then see how we're going to analyze this one. So to do the second part of the lab, you need this simulation. You can see the link here. Click on that, then the new simulator will appear. Okay. Any questions so far? Then you build this circuit. So you can see a capacitor. Okay, guys, any questions? So let's build this circuit quickly. So I need the capacitor, I need the resistor, and I need the switch, and I need a battery. Right, so that's all, very simple circuit. And then let's connect this one through here. Okay, and then let's connect this one through here. Then I have simple capacitor with the battery. Now remember, I need actually two circuit, right? One is capacitor charging, that is this one. I need also the capacitor discharging, right? I need another loop without battery connection, right? So which means let's make another loop with another switch, but there's no battery on there, that just the capacitor itself, capacitor and resistor itself. Okay. All right, so that's simple capacitor circuit. And then the capacitor value, you can see if you click on the capacitor, those values will show up here. The capacitance is now 0.1 micron, and resistor is now 10 ohms. If you calculate R value times C, that is the time constant, R is 10 ohm, capacitance is 0.1. So this will give you about 1 second, right? That is too small. So because of that, let's increase resistance of this capacitance into maybe like how about 50. So if I increase that into 50, let's take a look again, the tau. Now R is 50 ohms, capacitance is 0.1. Then I will get 5 seconds, right? So that's fairly considerable because I want to have a large number here because we're going to physically measure this, right? Physically, I need to have enough data points to actually make these graphs. Okay, so the graphs are look like exponentially growing. Because of that, you need to have at least 10 data points or more to get this nice shape, right? So that's the idea. So let's take a look now. Let's select this one, right? R is 50 ohms. And in the capacitance, let's keep it 0.1 farad. So the 0.1 farad is very large number. Generally, in lab setting, we don't have such large capacitance at all. We can have maybe like 0.1 millifarad, or maybe most of the capacitance are microfarad or nanofarad level. Okay, so let's make an Excel sheet. Table number 4. Table 4, capacitor charging, discharging. So you can say charging and discharging capacitor, discharging circuit analysis. You can name it according to any way you like. So I need actually three columns for each, right? Because we need voltage. If you take a look the last data table, I need the time and the voltage, and also I need the modified voltage because we are interested in making that linear shape graph, right? So I need the time. I need time, then I need voltage. Then I need modified voltage for the charging capacitor, that is Ln parentheses 1 minus parentheses V of C divide by V of 0, okay? So let me add another row here because I need this for charging capacitor and also I need the same for discharging capacitor, okay? Okay, for discharging capacitor, I again need the time and we need the voltage. And then for discharging capacitor, we need Ln parentheses V divided by V zero. Okay, so question. This is for charging, okay. Okay, so question. So this is for charging capacitor. Charging capacitor, discharging capacitor, all these three. And all of these for discharging capacitor. All of these for discharging capacitor, okay. I'm gonna use a different color to identify, then you can identify later if you're checking this. This for discharging capacitor. Okay, question. Okay, then let's continue. Now what you need is voltage as a function of time, right? So I need a voltmeter. Voltmeter probes should go between capacitor. That's where we're interested in measuring voltage. And volt switch should be initially on. Then I need a timer, right? So you can click this is stopwatch. Then you can bring the timer here. So that's our timer. Okay, now you can see just below here, there's a pause button, right? Make sure that pause button is switched on. And initially voltage between the capacitor should be zero, timer should be zero. Click this timer switch on, then you can see timer is actually moving, right? So make it to zero again. Click this button right here, pause button on. So that means the simulator is on pause mode. Then click the time button on, then you can see timer is not functioning because the simulator is paused, right? Now all we have to do, click this forward button once, then you can see timer went to point one and the capacitor doesn't show anything because the switch are off location, right? So make this into zero again, timer. Now we're interested in getting the time versus voltage for the charging capacitor, switch on the loop below, first loop, but make sure the loop above switch is open, okay? If you have the board switch closed, there's no meaning. At the time, I need only one circuit, okay? Charging circuit. Okay, now all set. So you again click this icon right here to make sure the timer is running. Now nothing is happening because the whole simulator is on pause mode. Click the forward button once. You can see time goes to 0.1. You can see a voltage here, right? Now you can start writing down voltage as a function of time. By clicking the forward button once, each 0.1 second, you can start typing the numbers. Or you can, we don't need actually each 0.1 second. That's going to be too much data maybe. We can do like each 0.2 second. So that's good enough. Click this forward button twice. Timer goes to 0.2, then you start typing the numbers for the timer, 0.2 now, 0.2 second. Make sure I need another column here to represent the units. I'm going to keep that row empty. Then first time is 0.2. Second, voltage across the capacitance is 0.35 volt. And then double click again this one, twice click, timer is 0.4. So you're doing something wrong. You have to observe your circuit first. When you make your circuit, circuit should be, when you make your circuit, it should be exactly look like mine, okay? So you have to have a capacitor, resistor, and then one loop with the battery. There should be a switch here. And then there should be another loop on the top. That switch should be at off location. And then before you start anything, make sure you click this icon right here, very below of the simulator. That should show look like this, which means this simulator is on pause mode. If simulator is running, you are already charging your circuit. There's no meaning you can take the data, you can't take the data. Okay, to take the data, your simulator should be in pause mode. Pause mode means this icon right here, very below of your page, it should be look like this arrow. Okay. And then you bring the timer, click the timer switch on, then you can identify your capacitor is working, but there's not happening anything because your whole simulator is on pause mode, okay? Then you collect the data, that's all really. I double click this one. Double click this. Type it, collect the time. Time is now 0.4, and then the voltage across capacitor. So my probes goes out. So you have to bring back there, right here. Voltage is 0.69. And then you continue. That's all really. Click twice. Capacitor is automatically set to 0.1. Don't change that. Leave it like that, okay? So the capacitor is 0.1 farad. Don't change that at all. And the resistor is set into 50 ohms. Resistor set into 50 ohms, okay? Those are the numbers we're using. Then my time constant, we expecting our expecting time constant tau. Expecting time constant is RC. That should be about 5 seconds. Okay, so that's what we're doing. Okay, good question. Okay, then let's continue. Double click this twice and then collect the data, okay? Let me go back again to the beginning and then show you again this one. There's a couple of questions for some people. Switch on this circuit and then switch close this one. Wait, the capacitor is fully discharging. You can see charges are slowly disappearing, but you have to wait, okay? That's going to take a while, couple of more seconds. You have to wait until this voltage show you zero, okay? So bring the voltage probe and then wait, capacitor is fully discharging. Still there's a voltage here. You can see it's slowly discharging at the end. Wait until show you zero. Okay, now it is zero, you can stop again. Now let's do this again. Okay, make sure your clock is showing zero. And make sure voltage probes are off. Make sure switch one is open, switch two is also open. Okay, both switch should be open location, open position. Capacitor should not have any charge, and then circuit should be looked like this. Okay, then bring your circuit, your voltage probes, put it, connect that end of the capacitor connection, and then voltage should show you zero. Okay, then make sure you can see now this right hand side very below, there's a blue color circle shows the two lines. Click on that once. Then your simulator is on pause mode, which means after you click that, if you click on your stopwatch in running mode, then you can see stopwatch is not running because whole simulator, now we in pause mode. Okay, simulator is not really running at all. That's why it's gonna run only if your right hand side very below this arrow, if you click that, then the simulator will start running. Okay. Now make sure the capacitor top loop is not connected. Okay, top loops right here. Switch number two should be on open location, open mode. Then close the switch one, that is for the charging circuit. You can see nothing is happening because whole simulator is on pause mode. Now click this forward button. You can see arrow and another line. That's a forward button. Click that twice. Then you can see timer goes, each click is timer going 0.1. So we're going to collect the data each 0.2 second. Okay. Now you can see timer telling you 0.2, voltage 0.35. You collect that data and then put it here on your table number 4, first two columns. Okay. That's what we needed. 0.2, 0.35 voltage. Then you click this forward button twice, timer 0.4, voltage is 0.69. Then click it twice again, timer now 0.6. And then measured voltage 1.02. And then likewise, you proceed this one. That's all. You have to click this forward button, otherwise you're not going to see anything. So if everything is zero, you're fine. Okay, so you click this forward button right here, right hand side very below. You can see these two icons, you have to click those buttons. Then your switch is not closed, you have to close this switch. You have to make sure this switch one is closed, and then you have to have a battery. All of the circuit should be connected. Your switch number two should be on off location. It should be look like that. If that switch is closed, nothing gonna happen. Okay, good. Did you get that? So what is wrong? What is different? Do you have the same circuit? Where's your voltage probes are? Do you have the voltage probe properly end of this circuit and end of this capacitor? Then your right hand side right here, you have this icon look like this. Then click on this button. That's all really. When you click that, did you see the timer is running each point, 0.1 at a time with each clock? Dominic? Do you have the resistor? What's the value of the resistor? What's the value of the resistor? What's the value of the capacitor? What's the value of the battery? Then I don't know what is going on. Then you have to take a look later. There's nothing else can go wrong. If you do everything correctly, everything should be working fine. So you have to take a look again. Delete the everything. Delete everything. Click this yellow button right here. If you click that yellow button, everything will be deleted, and then redo the circuit. Okay. So click this yellow color button, bring the capacitor. and then bring a resistor. Make sure resistor gonna go back to 50 ohms. And then bring a wire. Bring a switch. Bring a battery. And then these are like high school level circuits. Okay, these are not really like the work we supposed to do in our class. Then bring a voltage probes. Don't connect the other circuit, just connect only charging circuit at this point. You can see voltage is zero now. Make sure you click this blue button right here. Bring a stopwatch and then set up a stopwatch into the running mode. Everything should be zero. Now close this switch. Okay, now let's click this forward button twice, collect the voltage and the time. Click it twice, collect those numbers, 0.4. Okay, then collect this twice, 0.6, 1.02. Collect it twice again, 0.8. 0.8. Timer voltage is 1.33. And double click, 1.63. We can add this timer first one, 1.2, 1.4. If you highlight these two together and then click and drag, that will automatically calculate the rest. Okay, let's complete this one. Timer one, 1.63. 1.92, 2.2, 1.6, 2.46. Double click, 1.8, 2.72. Double click this one, 1.8. Double click this one, 2.2, 2.0 second, 2.97. Now you can see capacitor voltage is slowly increasing. Okay, it should show you that behavior. 3.2. And then 2.4, 3.43. And our time constant is 5, right? We have to go this to all the way to 5. Now you can see if you do this way, each point 2 by 2, then you have to type a lot of data, right? From 3 and up, we're going to do a little bit further away the data points, okay? So let's do 3.0 here. Let's do maybe up to 3 all the way to like this one. So the more the data is actually better. The curve should be look like good. After maybe 3.0, we can take the data each 0.4. That's fine, I think. 3.4 here, 3.8, 3.8. Then let's take the data each 0.4. Okay. Okay, following question. Now we are in 2.4, 2.6, 3.65. Double click this. 2.8, 3.86. Double click this. 3.0, 4.06. We're gonna go now 3.4, right? Directly. Look at the timer very carefully, then click carefully. Okay, 3.4, 4.44, and 3.8, 3.8, 4.79, and 4.2, 5.11, And I need 4.6 now. 4.6, 5.41. And continue likewise now, 5.69. And 5.4. I went all the way to 5.5. That's okay. Just click here 5.5, which is 6.0. And then we can go each 0.5 from there. Good, following. You're collecting the data. Anybody have any questions so far? So how I do this part right here, you can see you highlight the two cells and then click and drag, then the rest will automatically complete for you. Okay. When I go further and further away, I extend in the time difference. Okay. Initially I got each 0.2, later I got each 0.4. So then now I'm getting each 0.5. Okay. Or you can get each 1 second after this point. I think it's fine because initially we need a lot of data to see that behavior, exponential behavior. After you go up, we don't need that, like that many data points, okay? So we should be still fine. So the each time constant, each actually 5 seconds, right? So if you get the data 2 time constant and 3 time constant, then we have enough data point for our graph. Okay, so let's continue 6. Six point seven eight. We don't need a lot of data actually after this point. Let's minimize the data because of the time also passing out, right? So we are almost close to 10. So the 7 seconds, 6.78, 8 seconds. 6.78, why that changes into date mode. Okay, I know what's happening here. So you have to format all of these cell first. Otherwise, I think there can be an issue with the formatting of the cell. Okay, if you see anything changes into like date format or anything, the reason is actually your cell formatting. Okay, nothing to worry, just highlight all the cells and then right click. And then change the format cell into number format. Okay, then it should be fine. Okay. 6.78, 8.1 second, 7.22, 9 second, 7.51, 10 second, 7.78, 11 second. I went all the way to 11.1. If you miss that way, just write it down the new number. Okay, 11.1 doesn't matter. 11.1 second. 11.1 second. 8.02. Okay, I think that's good enough data. So we can take a look the analysis part for this one first. Okay. Okay, question. Anybody have any problem with collecting the data? Everybody have enough data set? At least you have to have like maybe 20 data points. That should be good enough. Now, you know, you can actually highlight this too. And then take a look quickly how the behavior look like. Insert. Scatter plot. Let me close a couple of other shared windows. I think due to some reason, it not allow me to do any graphing sometime if I have more windows shared. Okay, let me take a look quickly that. Hey guys, so my Excel sheet doesn't allow me to do the graph. Let me do a couple of things. Maybe I have to reopen the Excel sheet, then hopefully it will work fine. So let me do that quickly. Sometime it happens if I share many windows with this WebEx app, it not allow me to do all the graphing and all those stuff. So let me check that quickly. We have the data, we just need to make those two graphs, if not big deal. Component close curl and we know. Okay, so it's not still allow me to show you the graph actually. Okay, let me see how to solve this problem. Okay, so let us take a break. I might have to restart the computer. Okay, so let us take a break. It's 10 o'clock. So let us take 15 minutes break. If I restart the computer, so you have to make sure you log in again to the WebEx. Okay, because my Excel is not allow me to do anything when I share it. So that's problem sometime disappear if I restart the computer and or restart the WebEx might work, I think. Let me try that. By the time you take a break, we'll start in 15 minutes, okay? 10:15, and then we'll take 15 more minutes to finish this lab, and then we'll continue with the last chapter. So the lab is almost done. We just need to make the graphs, I think. So then we're fine. Good. Any questions so far? If you have any difficulty getting the collecting the data or anything, let me know. I can show you that again. Otherwise, I think if you have the data, we just need to do the graph. Okay, guys, so let's take a break. I will check this problem at that time. Okay, guys, so let us start. Anybody have any questions so far? Let me do this charging discharging capacitor again. I think earlier one of my computer is not working, so I'm gonna share that window by using a different computer. Okay, now see that, everyone see that window? Good. Any question? Okay, so let me do that part again, okay? But I'm gonna make a small circuit. So this is actually from the previous one, okay? Everybody got it? Let me show that calculation again, okay? So let me delete these two and then let me show you those two calculations again. Okay, now earlier we had these two lines, right? So this is actually time and the voltage accordingly. And then this column I calculated, I will show you that calculation again. Let me delete this. And then this calculation again. Okay, now let's draw a graph between voltage versus time. So the highlight two column, or you can highlight elsewhere, is scatter plot without anything first, and then double click there, and then add the data, select, add the new series, x values should be time, Y values should be voltage. Now, if you do Y versus T, you can see your graph look like exponentially growing, right? Slowly going towards the 9 volt, right? When it reach the 9 volt, it will saturate. We don't have the higher data here because it's gonna take a lot of time. That's why I stop from there, okay? Voltage is too high. Our time constant is too long too. If you have a shorter time constant, this charging process is actually much faster. Okay, everybody okay with that question? Anybody have any question? No question? Okay, so then let's continue. Okay, now let's take a look. I want to linearize this one, right? Linear to linearize, I need to have another column. Yeah, x-axis should be time, y-axis should be voltage, correct. Okay, to linearize, you remember earlier we developed a new equation, right? That equation equals sine ln, equals sine ln, parentheses, another parentheses, measure divide by the maximum voltage possible. Maximum voltage possible is 9 volt. Okay, divide by 9. One minus of this whole thing, and then close the parentheses again, and then hit enter button. Then you will get the ln of that. Then click and drag this the end of that data set. Okay. So let me increase this format, the font size a little bit, then you can see it clearly, I think. Okay, good. All right, then let's draw a new graph. Charts, insert, and then new data set, select the data, add the series. Now x values is still time, okay? X values doesn't change at all. However, y values is now, is this new column we calculated, okay? Remember, now we try to linearize that exponential graph. Now you will see linear graph, downward direction, slope is negative, but very linear. Now you add a trend line for this one. Click on this line, right click, trend line. Then you will get a trend line, linear, then click on option, and then you know all of these trees should be selected. There you go. Now you have a trend line. This should be visible, okay? You know how to format all these graphs. I'm not going to spend time on that. Graph should have to have a title, axis title, everything. You can do that formatting later. Now you see this time, this slope criteria, negative 0.199. That's the time constant, right? Let's calculate this time constant. Tau 1. That tau 1 should be now. Now you know tau 1 should be, this is the slope, right? From the slope, I have to calculate the tau 1. Tau 1, remember, previous equation which we developed, slope is equal negative 1 over tau, which means tau is equal negative 1 over slope, okay? Negative, negative cancels out, just 1 over slope, equal 1 divided by 1 over slope. Slope is 0.1999. So I'm getting 5.052, and then the tau calculator, we are expecting a tau value. Tau calculator, or tau expecting, you can see, which is equal R times C second, 5.0. So these two numbers are very close by. If I do the percentage difference between these two, equal sign ABS, 5 minus divided by 5 plus calculated value divided by 2 multiplied by 100. Multiplied by 100. So I'm getting about like 0.05 difference. So the difference is extremely small, okay? Reformat all of this cell. We don't need actually this many significant figures. You can reformat all of these to format cells, maybe like 2 decimal places, right? So that's good enough number. Good in question. So let's complete the discharging circuit very quickly, okay? Everybody okay with that? So let's complete the discharging circuit then. To do the discharging circuit, let me share this window again. V0 is the maximum possible voltage, that is the 9 volt. That's a given voltage here, 9 volt, okay? Now you have to let this, run and then wait until it reach 9 voltage. Click this run button right here, play button, right hand side very below. Wait until the voltage becomes 9 volt, because we have to reach 9 volt to do the discharging, okay? We could start discharging before it reaching 9 volt, but it's better to start until it fully charge. Then we'll make a discharging circuit. Okay, 9 volt. Now you can stop this one and click the timer back into 0, because we're going to start the timer again. Now you can see it's 9 volt. Now make this switch on, switch off. Now you disconnect the charging circuit. Let's make the discharging circuit now. I need another wire here. Another wire here. And now we need another switch. And another wire here connected to the other. Now I have a discharging circuit here, okay? Charging circuit should be break. This switch one should be off. And discharging circuit switch on. Now I have a discharging circuit. Now all I have to do, collect the data, right? So click this icon. Let's collect discharging circuit, maybe each 0.5 time period. That's good enough, I think, because earlier time period is too long, right? Let's do each 0.5, or even one second even is fine, I think. So let's do each 0.5. So 8.14. I'm using two computers actually. You won't see my Excel sheet right now, but I will show you Excel sheet after I finish the data. Okay, we collecting the data each 0.5 second. Okay. Each 0.5 second voltage is 8.14. Don't put the zero, okay? Zero time is not important because since we're getting ln, you will get the error there, 8.14. And after 1 second, 7.3 second, 7.37. Just click the forward button and then get the voltage after for each 0.5, okay? 6.67. I went directly to the 4.0. I skip actually 3.5. That's okay. Just give me that data point. Okay, fine. 4.0 is 4.04. 4.5, 3.66. 2.71. You can see now voltage is decreasing much faster rate. 6.6, 2.40. 8 data point doesn't matter, whatever the number you have, write it down. Okay, you don't need to necessarily go each 0.5. 7.0, 2.22. 7.5, 2.01, 8.0, 1.82, 8.5, 1.64, and then so on. That's good enough, I think, to get the nice linear behavior, I think. Okay, let's continue from there. Let's continue a little bit more data because then you will see the shape actually. 9.0, 1.49. 1.49. After 9.0, continue in 1 second. I will go into 10 seconds, 11 seconds, and so on. 1 second, a little bit more data. Now we are on 9 seconds. Let's go to 10 seconds directly. 10 seconds, 1.22. 11 seconds. 1.0, 12 second, 0.82. Now you can see the voltage is much, much less now, right? 0.82, 13 second. I have actually 13.1. Make sure you read that carefully, 0.65. But I have to put 13.1 here for the voltage. That's okay. 14 second, 0.55. 15 second, 0.45. 16 second, 0.37. 17 second, 0.30. 18 second, 0.25. Okay, that's good enough data. Okay, now let's see. I'm gonna share you my other window. Everybody okay with the discharging circuit? Good. I'm gonna stop this window and then let me share the other window. I'm on two different continents, that's why, okay, you will not see the same, you can't see the both circuit and the data set together. Okay, everybody see the Excel sheet, good? Good now, right? Good. So now let's take a look how the discharging capacitor works. Now these two graphs, I'm going to put it close by each other here. These two graphs represent the charging circuit, okay? Charging circuit, make them both visible. This is for the charging circuit. Okay, now let's take a look at the discharging circuit. Now I have the voltage and the time. So let's do more graphs again. One graph here. Select the data set. The series x-axis is time again. And the y-axis is now voltage again. Now hit it. Now you can see it exponentially decreasing, right? See the behavior? That's the behavior, right? But I don't interested the behavior itself. What we interested is actually ln versus the version of that. Then we can calculate the time constant, right? So I need equal sign ln voltage divided by maximum voltage is 9 volt. Hit enter. Then do this calculation for all the data. I get rid of this line right here. I have extra line data point. Okay, now it makes another graph, scatter plot. Scatter plot, and plot, I need the graph. Select the data, series, x-axis is still time. Now y-axis is ln version of the velocity, okay, not the ln version of the voltage, not the voltage itself. And the button, now you can see again negative slope, nice linear graph, right? So I need to have I need to fit that data with the trend line, add trend line, linear trend line, linear, and option, click all these three on the below. Y-intercept 0, display equation, display R-squared. R-squared is actually telling you how good or bad your fitting is, right? Now again, I have my Y is close to 0.2, right? We expecting that actually, right, 0.2. So we're gonna get the right answer then. Little bit of data there, so that's going to give us a very perfect number. This is tau 2, right? This is for the discharge. Calculate tau 2 by that is equal by slope of the graph. So the tau expected is 5. Tau from RC, which is 5.0 seconds, which means take different for that, I will get 0. Let's format this also to represent three significant figures. All format cell number, two decimal places mean you will get three significant figures. Okay, question. Everybody get that idea? Everybody okay with the charging discharging circuit? Now you have these four graphs. You have to include all four graphs, and then you have to write it down, discussion about the behavior of the charging discharging circuit for the last data set. This circuit we're going to revisit in our experiment number 9. Okay, experiment number 9, we're going to redo this same circuit by using the oscilloscope, by applying the AC voltage, and then see how the circuit behavior with the AC voltage. At that time, we're going to revisit this experiment again. and then remeasure the time constant by using the oscilloscope. Okay. All right, any questions so far? Everybody okay with that? Everybody have the data? Everybody should have all the graphs? Everybody have all the other data table completed? I think we can stop this lab right now. From here, there's then we can continue the last chapter actually. All right, guys, any question? Everybody okay? Table number three, sure. Good. Table number three, remember, which one we see actually? We did not see anything. Table number one and two, we calculated everything. I let you guys do this calculation, okay? One question for table number one and another question for table two. And then I let you guys to try table number three, these two calculations, okay? You don't need the simulation or anything again. These are just calculated values, okay? All those, the rest of the work, whatever you have to do is only calculated values. You don't need the simulation at all, okay? All the simulation and everything we've done. Okay, and then make sure you format this this data table before you copy paste into your lab report, and then make sure all these graphs should have to have a graph top name, topic for the graph, title for the graph, axis name, units and everything, okay? And then you have everything here, whatever you need for the report, okay? Good. Any questions so far? Everybody okay? Okay, guys, then let's continue to our chapter number 10 work. So we have a lot of work to do there. So let's continue.